This is map drawing 10, the Greater Antilles. The Greater Antilles include Cuba, Hispaniola, Jamaica, and Puerto Rico. You don't need anything fancy for this drawing, just your pencil, pen, eraser, and possibly your ruler to draw the Tropic of Cancer in at the end of the drawing. I'd like to put my paper this way for this drawing. If you want to put your paper the other way, you can do that too, because we're just going to be drawing some islands in the middle. We're not going to be measuring out from the sides or anything, but I think the islands fit better on the paper if it's like this. And you're going to start by going down to this corner, lower right, but not all the way in the corner. Come up a little bit like this, and you're going to make an oval that's a little bit smaller than an egg. Maybe the size of a pigeon egg or something. And right behind this oval, you're going to draw a smaller oval, maybe the size of two peas sitting next to each other. And then right here, you're going to make a little curve going out. And under that, you're going to make a longer curve coming out like this. Now, if you look in the picture in the book that goes with this, the picture of map drawing 10, you can see the silly cartoon fish that I imagine this island into. And I've called it the Haitian gulper fish. And there is no such thing as the Haitian gulper fish. So if you go looking for it in online or on a science encyclopedia, you won't find it. So don't try. This fish's eye would be right about like this. And its gills would be, you don't have to draw these in. But this is how the fish would go. So that this would be the mouth area and this would be like the tail. But you don't have to draw those in. Those are just to help you imagine which way the fish is swimming. Now, with just these lines, we're ready to draw. I'm going to start up here. We're going to go around this top curve like this, down till we touch the oval, follow the oval for a little piece, and then we're going to go around this. Don't touch the line, just go on either side of it. And there's actually a little tiny bump there. It looks like a tooth or something. And then down on this side like this, and then along the oval just a little bit. And then right in the middle here, there actually is a thing going down like this. It looks like it would be like a lower fin or something. And then around the back tail there. And then there's a little bump like this, maybe kind of a little dorsal fin. And then over the top like that. And there's a little island that sits right here. It looks like a crumb. If this is a fish, it looks like the fish is about to swallow that little thing, whatever it is. And right behind the fish, there's a little kind of oval-shaped island, and that's Puerto Rico. It's maybe the baby that's following its mother. All right, now we're ready to put in the next island, and we need to draw a line up from the bottom of the jaw and line over from the top jaw, like that. And this is going to be our starting point, is to make a triangle. Now, the size of this triangle, if you put this triangle inside the Hispaniola fish here, the gulper fish, this would be about the same. Now you can see I need to make mine a little bit bigger. That was maybe a little too small, so I'll go like this. Does that look about right? Looks like it would fit in there, doesn't it? Okay. And next, I'm going to draw a line going out like this. Now, this kind of reminds me, if this was the head of a vacuum cleaner, one of those upright vacuums, and then this would be like, this would be where the bag is, and this would be the handle where the switch is, like that. You hold it like this, the vacuum. So that's why I call this fish the Cuban vacuum cleaner fish. And once again, it's not a real fish, so don't bother going trying to look it up online and find out about it, because it won't be there. Okay, we can start with our pen. I'm going to start right here and go around. I'm going to smooth out the point here. It's not make it too pointy. Kind of wiggle a little bit. It's pretty flat along the bottom of Cuba, though. You can make a few little wiggles, but kind of curve around that point like that and make a little tiny bump. And then when you come up to here, the top of the triangle, we're going to make a bump that will look like the eye on the far side of the head. So if this were a real fish, you don't have to draw this, but I'm going to show you. One eye would be like this, and then you'd kind of see the other place where this eye comes up, sort of like that. But you don't have to draw on the eye. All right, let's keep going up the back. Now stay well away from this line. Our lines are going to go out and around like this. We're going to draw kind of a bumpy back. It's almost like a alligator back. And you can see the picture of it in the book, the little cartoon fish picture. Okay, when we get to the tail, we're going to make it, it kind of reminds me of a gecko tail or maybe a scorpion tail. It has a little bump and like a stinger thingy on it. And then we're going to make a little back, like a leg or a foot or something right there, a flipper, whatever you want to imagine it as. Come back along here, go in, and then we're going to make a bump for the what I imagine to be the gill area. If it were a real fish, this is maybe where the gills would be, but you don't have to draw on the gills. And then this also has a little baby island right there. This baby a little bit smaller, it's younger, it's maybe it's just an egg or something. Okay, and the last island is you go down from the side of the head, straight down like this, and then over from the lower jaw of that fish. And this is about the location of Jamaica. And Jamaica doesn't really have any shape that's really interesting. It kind of looks like a blob, and you can imagine it, maybe it's a cookie or something, and these guys are kind of swimming, racing to see who can be the first one to eat Jamaica. All right, I'm going to erase my guidelines. So little cute eyeballs and everything. And let's do some labeling. Let's label this island. The correct name for this whole island is Hispaniola. H-I-S-P-A-N, Hispaniola, Hispaniola. But the island's divided, if you want to make kind of a dotted line, the head of this fish is called Haiti, H-A-I-T-I. And of course, Haitian, the name of the fish, Haitian gulper fish, is named after the country of Haiti. And the back end of the fish is the Dominican Republic, Dominican Republic. Now, of course, this is baby Puerto Rico. P-U-E-R-T-O, Puerto Rico, R-I-C-O. And that actually means rich port. Okay, it's labeled Jamaica, J-A-M-A-I-C-A, and Cuba. And this little island here is called the Isle of Youth. And that may sound like a nice place to have a vacation, but actually the government of Cuba uses at least part of this island as a federal prison, so it's not a good place to vacation. Alrighty, let's put in the Tropic of Cancer. We want to draw a line right above the top of Cuba. Don't touch it, just go slightly above it. And you can either put in a dashed line or straight line, doesn't matter. I think I'll make mine dashed just to make it look nice. And this is going to be the Tropic of Cancer. And this line, knowing where these islands are in relation to this line, will help you when you go to draw your world map to be able to locate Cuba and Hispaniola correctly on the world map. If you know that they're just under the Tropic of Cancer, that'll help you a lot when you go to do your final drawing. Now, if you'd like to add more things, like to look at a map or a atlas and label some cities or something, you're welcome to do so, but that's all I'm going to do for my map.